Well, we officially made it down here in Antioch. Let me tell you, the nerves are actually kind of starting to set in here. This track is not how it looks on, you know, picture or video, I guess, if you watch flow racing or whatnot. It is way more banked. The first time here in person, we're standing at the top of turn three on the entry to turn three. It looks pretty good though. I mean, the track looks pretty dry right now, so I think it's gonna be pretty dry, slick, possibly rubber. I don't know how it's gonna work with all these big fender cars or whatnot, because mainly I go to sprint car races with Tanner, so we'll see here, but I'm excited to get underway here. This is gonna be a lot of fun. Like I said, first time to Antioch Speedway. Hopefully we can get some good laps under our belt and have a decent car count for tonight. Well, it's go time here at Antioch Speedway. Time to warm the car up. We're not gonna be doing mud pack, but we are gonna go straight into hot laps. I will jump right to the GoPro from there. I might have someone film from the pit stands. I don't know, it's kind of not the best view from the pits like some other tracks are, but we will see. But anyways, I'll see you guys all on the GoPro for hot laps. So finally, the first laps are complete here at Antioch. After probably about sitting in the car for 20 minutes, the anticipation built up, and then it was just like, all right, I'm ready to get out of here. I'm ready to go on the track. We finally got out there, worked the track in a little bit so I could kind of feel it. Wow, it's a lot different. Last time I turned laps, it was kind of like hooked up and wet in Coos Bay. This is like, there's grease on exit, but then it's like kind of hard and a little rough. So it's a little weird to me, and I'm still trying to feel that suspension. So I dove it in there a couple times and one and two just leaned over, but I'm still like kind of feeling when I need to catch it right and all that stuff, and I don't want to get too sideways. But I think if it goes dry slick, if it's around the bottom, I think I'll be good. But I think I'm gonna have to definitely run it a little bit harder. It felt like it was maybe kind of falling flat on its face coming out of the corner. I think I was in third gear or whatnot, but no, the car ran really good. It felt good. The first laps are done, so now we just gotta improve. I felt like I could hang at least with that white car or whatnot, but we'll see what we can do, and we're gonna go have some fun in the heat race. Okay, so we are on a quick intermission here. You just saw the track right there. It is getting slick, and I want that. That's perfect. I've been really looking forward to running a slick track like this, where there's grip in some parts, slick on the other, but it looks like there's a lot of kind of grip. You can see this like cushion layer, but it's a little rough up there. So I don't know what to expect here. I don't know if we're doing 20 or 25 laps, but either way, this is going to be a lot of fun. All I care about is just getting more experience running laps around here and getting more comfortable in the car. The slick here is pretty fun. You just let it slide, 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 catch the grip, and then you're just, you know, back up on the throttle trying to get out of the corner. These other guys are really fast. Like I said, I'm down on gearing, but other than that, the car feels really good, and these guys are awesome. Everyone in the Dwarf car community is so cool and very helpful to us. So many people have offered tips and advice already today, and it's cool. You love to see it, and that's why I love this class so much. But anyways, down here at Antioch, the track is looking good, at least what I want to see. Slick in some parts, grip in the other. If it was slick all the way through, that'd be really cool with two lanes, top and bottom, in the grip. But for what we got, I hope they don't work it, and we have a fun A main event, and we roll her in the box. We are starting fifth, so let's see how we do. Fun. I try to run third gear with, you know, our wrong rear end gear, and it made a world of difference. I had so much more drive. I hope the GoPro caught, you know, most of all of it, but I ran the bottom and I kind of stayed with them, and then I got a little loose on entry, just kind of driving it in too hard, and then I went to the middle of the top a little bit, you know, probably a lane or two higher than the front guys were running, and I started catching them for probably 15 laps or so, or, you know, 12. I was catching them through the middle, and then at one point I threw it in too hard and just got way too tight, so it went like slick to grip. Obviously you're really slick on entry, but I was driving it in so much deeper than the rest of the guys in front of me, and we were catching them, and then after that they pulled away, and then I started driving it a little harder to catch back up, and then I made another mistake, but holy cow, that was fun. I started to catch some of the other people that started to bobble when he got really slick. At the end there, I went to the bottom, and the rear end kind of spun, and I was like, what was that? And so it was like I was giving it gas, and it was just running RPM, but not going anywhere. So just to be safe, I pulled her into the infield. I could smell a little bit of a burning smell. So in the laps prior, I kind of went to the bottom, because I was like, well, it's kind of weird. And then, I think our motor builder that's here with us, Todd Thompson, said we probably just smoked the clutch in it. But that's what happened. We did not finish, so a DNF, but still, we were catching those guys. And it felt really good to finally get on the gas and trust the car and see what she's really made of. So we're going to get ready to go ahead and load up here. It's still daylight, which is pretty nice. We got a 3-hour drive back home. But anyways, Antioch was a lot of fun. I really want to come back here. I cannot wait to go to Southern Oregon. This division's really fun. But anyways, a big thank you to all my sponsors, all my partners that were on board today. You guys really helped me out a lot. Big thanks to Todd Thompson for coming all the way down there, building a bullet motor. And what can I say? I cannot wait to get back on track at Southern Oregon Speedway in 2 weeks. This was a ton of fun.
So we finally got home around 1 to 2 a.m. last night, got some good sleep, and now we are back up today. I'm getting ready to go wash the race car, which I will make a video about that here, but I'm going to end this video here with a couple of words. Antioch Speedway was awesome. Everyone down there was great. Even the competitors that I was racing with, very friendly and very helpful towards me. I cannot wait to get back down to Antioch. I know on our schedule I'm going to be racing June 18th up in Medford, so if I can fit Antioch back in the schedule sometime later in the year, I will. But as of right now, I just don't have it on the schedule. So fingers crossed we can go back. A big thank you to everyone down there. They're so cool. And the pits and the track was awesome. The track was actually perfect for my liking, slick to grip. And it was a fun racy track. Last night was a lot of fun. Got to actually turn a good amount of laps in the car. Got pretty comfortable with it. And I think all we can do is move forward from here. So once again, a big thank you to all my sponsors and my partners. Thank you to Todd Thompson for coming down with us, and my parents and my girlfriend for helping support me. And last but not least, all of you, all the fans on the channel, everyone that follows my racing. Thank you to you for all of the support. It means a lot. And let's go wash a car. I'll see y'all in the next video.